Students, so far we have discussed about open loop and closed loop systems, but you may thought that what is the difference between these two and where they are applied. So the main difference with both the systems are open loop system does not contain any feedback devices, but closed loop system contains a feedback device that is not only limited to sensor, any kind of feedback devices. And another difference is the circuitry associated with closed loop system is complex, and but for open loop system it is very simple. So being simple, open loop system circuitry are less cost, but closed loop system are somewhat sophisticated. So if any industry that runs and the main, if their main motive is to reduce the cost by compromising the accuracy, then they can able to use open loop system. Otherwise, closed loop system is the main necessity. So closed loop system involves higher accuracy with sophistication. Next, we will discuss about some other basic things that are required about NC machines. So we know that there are three possible movements in a NC machine, namely X, Y, Z, and Z represents the spindle movement. That means this is the Z movement. So a tool can travel from to and fro in this direction. So this is Z movement, and this is longitudinal table movement. This is called X. And next one is Y. Y is associated with saddle. So this is a saddle movement. So we can control any NC machine in three mutually perpendicular directions. Next one is tool motion control systems. Yes, we can able to control the tool independently in NC machines. So there are three varieties, like the control systems we discuss, open loop and control loop. So that is concerned with entire control systems, but what we are going to study is only deals with tool motion control system, only for tool motion. So there are three different control systems for tool motion. One is point-to-point system or positioning system. Second one is straight cut system. And third one is contouring system or continuous path system. Let us discuss one by one. So first one is point-to-point systems. So before discussing what is meant by point-to-point system, so first we will discuss this example. So in my example, I need to drill four holes on a rectangular plate. So first, second, third and fourth hole. So first what we'll do is first drill a hole on a particular place and retract the tool and place the tool in the some other path and again performing the drilling operation and again retract the tool from that position and again do the drilling operation in third position and so on. So this is called point to point system. That means we are performing the required operations at particular points, but while the tool movement, that means while the tool moves from one place to another place, there is no material removal during the path of the tool. So that is called point to point. It only performs the necessary operation at particular point from at particular points. It does not bother about the path traveled. So this is called point to point system. A conventional drilling operation is the best example for this system. The second types of tool control system is, here the tool will move parallel or perpendicular to any different axes. So while moving, so the tool cut the required or unwanted material in the form of chips. So here the tool will move from one location to another location, and during the movement itself the material will be removed. So this is called straight cut system. But one of the main thing associated with this system is it does not control or does not remove material in angular direction. It only moves in parallel or perpendicular direction for the axes. This is called straight cut system. And the typical example for this system is end milling operation or any milling operation. And third tool motion control system is contouring system or continuous path system. This system involves complex geometry or complex contour of workpieces. So this is the most difficult and sophisticated control system for tool motion control. So the major differences between each and every types of tool motion control systems is, again, it is related to circuitry. So the circuitry and accuracy associated with third system is complex, but the previous two systems is somewhat easier. So according to the necessity, you can select whatever types of circuitry I want. Suppose if you are running some just a drilling machine, you can install point to point systems circuitry and perform your operations. That involves lesser cost and sufficient operations. But if you are running a milling machine and you want to do all the required operations on that milling machine, you have to install contouring system, because it involves both longitudinal as well as transverse as well as depth direction movement of tool. So it is the most complex control system for tool movement. So by necessity, or for the necessity, you can select whatever the systems you want. Next one is programming modes or tool positioning in NC machines. So I already said at the end of this unit we will develop a part program, but while developing any program we need a reference point. Based on that reference point only we will develop such kind of programs. But so based on the reference points, we can select or we can pick two systems. One is absolute and second one is incremental system. Let us discuss the one by one of these two systems. So first one is absolute system. So first take this example. So it is a plate, and in this plate I want to drill three holes, namely 1, 2, and 3. So this is a machine reference or tool reference point, namely 0, 0, or origin of this workpiece. So first my drilling cutter will be moved from this location to this location. So for that movement we have to put input as, in x axis it is 10 and it is y axis is 10. So if you are enter 10, 10, my tool, drilling tool, will automatically go to this place and perform the drilling operation. Next one is, if I want to drill in the second slot, again I have to give some input values. So what absolute system represents is, each and every value for the any particular position should be taken from the absolute origin. So this is called absolute origin. So any value has to be taken this point as reference. So for drilling the drilling in position 2, we have to give input as 30, 20 in x axis and y axis. Again, so in for position 3, we have to give input as 50, 30. So by this way absolute system programming works, and you will know lot more while doing the part programs. Second one is incremental system. So here again the same requirement, drilling 3 holes and 3 different locations. So first we will start with drilling of hole in this slot 1. So for this point, as usual, we have to give reference point as 10, 10. But while drilling the second point, the reference point is this point number 1. That means incremental systems involves the reference point for any operation is nothing but the previously machined operation is the reference point for the next operation. This is called incremental. In absolute, all for all the slots the reference point is 0, 0, but in incremental, reference point for a particular operation or particular slot is the machined one of previous slot. So the inputs for slot 2 here is 20, 10, and for this 3 is 20, 10. So by this way we have to give input to this incremental system. So far we have discussed about NC machines. Now we will discuss about CNC machines.